week, we showed you how Olympic athlete hero Ken Patera fell under the influence of Bobby the Brain Heenan. But the true tragedy began innocently enough, late on a snowy night in Waukesha, Wisconsin, when a hungry Ken Patera went to a fast food restaurant after a grueling match. According to newspaper reports, Ken Patera was denied service, told that the restaurant was closed for the night. It is alleged that Ken Patera and a co-defendant threw a rock through the restaurant window, resulting in a call to the police. The police arrived at Ken Patera's motel, and a melee ensued between a number of local police, Ken Patera, and a co-defendant. Patera was arrested and charged with the felony. He went to trial and was found guilty. In these days of rapists, kidnappers, and murderers, plea bargaining for a fraction of their sentences, or even getting off scot-free, Patera was sentenced to 2 years in prison. There were many who felt that a first-time offender, a man who represented his country in international competition, should not have received such a harsh sentence. Who's to blame? The judicial system? Society? Or does Ken Patera bear the full brunt on his own wide shoulders? And what was it like for a man in the prime of his career to spend two long, hard years in prison? Let Ken Patera tell you.
I accept full responsibility for my actions. Nobody's above the law. Nobody knows that better than Ken Patera. I accept full blame for it. I should have never listened to people like Bobby Heenan, somebody that creates a problem and just walks away. When I was down, I need moral support. There was no phone calls, no letters, no visits. You completely abandoned me, Bobby. What was it like sitting in jail, being in prison? The disgrace I brought upon my loved ones, my family, my friends, the disgrace I brought up myself. I hope to make it right by ridding the world of people like you, Bobby Heenan. I paid for my mistake, and I will be coming back.